Test, test. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. How are we all doing today? This is the day that the Lord has made. This is the day that the Lord has made. Praise God. If you can all please stand up. If you could greet your neighbor, your first choice, tell them that was your first choice. If you could turn to choice number two, don't greet the same person twice, amen. We're continuing our 21 days of consecration and fasting. There's information on the back for it. A best way to learn and with your experience and whatnot is to communicate with your fellow brethren. Amen. Best way to change recipes, prayers, and anything else. It's a lot easier to do things together. For more info, you can go to the back visitor center and get information about fasting. This Saturday, we want everyone to come to our general assembly. That's 6 a.m. to noon. That's this Saturday. We will have childcare, and this is an important time for the church to pray and fast together. Amen. This Tuesday, we also like to invite you to prayer. And this Wednesday is our corporate prayer as well. Amen.
Excited to be in the house of the Lord. Amen. David said in Psalm 27, amen. David said in Psalm 27, one thing have I desired of the Lord, and that will I seek, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord. Not just to come and enjoy and sit around and look, but so that I can behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. Amen. And so I wonder how many people came here today seeking the face of God. Amen. With a hunger to see God. Amen. Manifesting himself in our midst, and with a hunger to see God even manifesting himself in your heart, in your life. If that's you here today, why don't you just begin to lift up a sacrifice of praise. Amen. Begin to just lift up a sacrifice of thanksgiving unto the Lord Most High, because he's worthy to be praised. Hallelujah, Jesus. Exalt you, Lord. You are King of kings and Lord of lords, God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In the presence of the Lord, there's fullness of joy, and at his right hand, pleasures forevermore. Hallelujah. And so, Lord, we've come, God, to gather together in the name of Jesus, one mind, one body, one mind and one accord, Lord, to exalt you, to glorify you, God, so that you, Lord, can come and dwell among your people, Jesus. We love you, God. We thank you, Lord. All right, let's all celebrate the King of Glory. We're going to celebrate the King of Glory. Hallelujah. Celebrate him with your praise.
Everything. Let's lift his name on high. Come on, Zion, we praise our King.
Celebrate our
ruler
King.
Of everything. Let's lift his name on high.
Let's lift
come on, Zion, we praise our King. Of days. Let's lift his name on high. Come on, Zion. excellent King.
He's worthy of all of our praise.
Righteous and glorious, come on Zion, we praise our King. Come on, lift your hands. Let's celebrate our King.
Celebrate our King.
He's the ruler of everything. Let's lift His name on high. Come on, Zion.
We praise our King.
He's worthy of all praise. He's the Lord God and Ancient of Days. Let's lift His name on high. Come on and praise the Lord. He's awesome and glorious, excellent King. He's worthy of all of our praise, righteous and glorious. Let's praise Him, righteous and glorious, ever victorious. He's reigning over us. He's a great God,
righteous and glorious,
ever victorious. He's reigning over us. He's a great God, righteous and glorious, ever victorious. He's reigning over us. He's a great God. Come on, begin to tell Him how great He is, how awesome He is. He reigns. Righteous and glorious, ever victorious. He's reigning over us. He's a great God. Oh, you're a great God. You're a holy God. Oh, He's a great God. He's a great God.
He's a great God.
He's a great God.
He's a great God.
He's a great God.
He's a great God.
He's a great God.
He's a great God.
He's powerful and holy.
He's a great God.
He reigns over everything.
He's a great God.
Nothing He withholds from the righteous.
He's a great God.
Oh, He's a great God. Come on, say, He's a great God.
He's a great God.
Oh, He's a great God.
He's a great God.
He's healed my body.
He's a great God.
Oh, He's touched my mind.
He's
I'm gonna celebrate
God.
The holiness, the righteousness
he's
of God.
God.
Oh, He's holy. He's holy.
He's
come on, lift your
God.
Voice. He's a great God.
He's a great God,
righteous and glorious, ever victorious. He's reigning over us.
He's a great God.
Oh, come on and lift your voice. I'll praise Him every morning. Hallelujah.
Oh,
I'll exalt the name of the Lord.
Oh,
I'll shout it from the rooftops.
Oh,
He's powerful and holy.
He's a great God.
Oh, come on, what is your praise on your lips? Come on.
He's
great. He's healed you. He's set you free. Salvation and honor. Glory and power. He's a great God.
He's a great God.
Righteous and glorious, ever victorious. He's reigning over us.
He's a great God.
Oh, come on, lift up some praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, we declare the Lord powerful and mighty in this place. We lift Him up higher than the problem. We lift Him higher than the world. We lift Him higher than government. He reigns over every nation, every creed, every race. He's awesome and powerful. We declare it in this house, God. We declare the power. We declare Your presence in this place. God, when You come in this place, miracles happen. Blessings fall down. Healings and miracles. You are holy in this place. You are righteous. We declare it with our lips. Come on. Lift a praise unto the Lord. He's a great God. Righteous and glorious. Ever victorious. He's reigning over us. He's a great God. Yes. Hallelujah. Come on, from the fruit of your lips, give Him praise, give Him glory, give Him honor, give Him honor, give Him honor, give Him honor, give Him glory. Praise Him,
Praise him for who he is. Hallelujah. Come on, declare his presence. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He's worthy. Hallelujah.
I mean, you know that the Lord is a warrior and he's fighting on our behalf. Come on, let's put our hands together like this all over the room. Come on, every sickness. Sickness, every disease.
It has to bow.
In the name of Jesus, fear and depression.
Fear and depression at Calvary. Finally free in the name
every
of Jesus.
Sickness.
Every sickness.
Every disease.
Every disease.
It has to bow.
It has to bow. In the
fear
name
and depression. Yeah.
Fear and depression.
It can't worry me.
Can't worry me.
Finally free.
I'm finally free in
say
the name
every
of Jesus.
Sickness.
Every sickness.
And every disease.
And every disease. It has to bow. In the
fear
name
and depression.
Fear and depression.
It can't worry me. Because I'm finally free.
I'm finally free.
Say, you are mine.
You are my
warrior.
Warrior. You are my warrior. You are my
warrior.
Warrior. You are my.
Say, great Jesus, great.
Great Jesus.
You are
my warrior.
Say, strong.
Strong tower. You are my warrior.
Great Jesus.
Great Jesus.
Strong tower,
strong tower,
and you fight and you fight for me. I need somebody to just put their hands together. Come on. If you know that we're not fighting a losing battle, sing it with us right here. Say
every sickness and every disease,
it has to bow.
It has to bow in the
fear and depression. Lord.
Fear and depression.
Can't worry.
It can't worry me.
Finally free.
I'm finally free in the name
every
of Jesus.
Sickness.
It has to bow. It has to bow. The
fear and depression, Lord.
Fear and depression, it can't worry me.
Finally free.
I'm finally free.
Cause you are mine.
You are my warrior.
Warrior.
You are my
warrior.
Warrior.
So
you are my
warrior.
Warrior.
So
you are my.
Say, great Jesus, great Jesus.
Great Jesus.
You are.
Says the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but they're mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds. Let's pull down some strongholds today and begin to fight this fight of faith. Come on and sing this part with us like this. It's gonna stay right here.
Stay right here.
Gonna let you do it.
Let you do it.
Gonna hold my peace.
Gonna hold my peace.
And let you fight. Gonna stay right here.
Stay right here.
Gonna let you do it.
Let you do
gonna hold my peace.
Hold my peace.
And let you fight.
Fight for me.
Stay right here.
Stay right here.
Gonna let you do
gonna
it.
Let you do it.
Hold my peace.
Hold my peace. And let you fight for me.
Stay right here.
Stay right here.
Gonna let you do
gonna
it.
Let you do
gonna
it.
Hold my peace.
Hold my peace. And let you fight.
Oh, I'm gonna stay right here.
Stay right here.
Right here, right here.
Gonna stay right here.
Gonna stay right here.
Right here, right here.
Gonna stay right here.
Stay right here.
Right here, right here.
Right here, right here.
Gonna stay right here.
Right here,
right here.
Gonna let you do it.
Let you do it.
Let you do it.
Let you do it.
Gonna move.
Let you do it.
Gonna stay.
Let you do it.
Salvation of the Lord.
Let you do it.
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 Gonna let you do it.
Let you do it.
Gonna let you do it.
Let you do it.
You can fight for me.
Gonna
let you do it.
Gonna let you do it.
Yeah.
Stay right here.
Stay right here.
Gonna let you do it.
Gonna let you do it.
Stay right here.
Stay right here.
Gonna let you do it.
Gonna let you do it.
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 I'm not gonna step in.
Let you do it.
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 Let you do it. Let you do it.
Say great Jesus. Say great Jesus.
Great Jesus.
Say great Jesus.
Great Jesus.
Great Jesus.
Great Jesus.
Strong tower.
Strong tower.
Strong tower.
Zephaniah chapter 3 says that God is in our midst and he is a mighty warrior fighting on our behalf, bringing forth victory. Today there is great joy in the house of the Lord. Amen. I don't know. I saw here. Is Brother Carlos here? Amen. You know, the book of Acts talks about Peter being in prison and the church was praying and God did a miracle. Amen. And Brother Carlos, he got into some trouble before he came to the Lord. And no matter what trouble you get into, there's always a way out. It's through Jesus Christ. He's our way out. He's our deliverance. That's what the choir. I'm trying to increase your faith because this song is somebody's testimony. And they told him they wanted to give him over 18 years. 17 years of prison time. The judge said, we're going to give you 8 years. You're going to have to go to prison. And so we said our final goodbyes. I was in Florida and we Skyped each other. We prayed and the body of Christ just kept on believing for a miracle. God, you can do a miracle. This is a child of God. This is a baby in the Lord. He's a new creature in the Lord. And the judge comes into the chambers one day, getting ready to sentence him and send him off. And she says, I've never done this. I don't know why I'm doing this. But I'm going to give you 6 months. What should have been 17, what should have been 8 years, was 6 months. How long has it been? 5 months. They say, Carlos, find a ride. You're done. You're going home. Church, Brother Carlos isn't just visiting us. This is a miracle by the grace of God. God has done a work in his life. And so when they say deliverance, it is somebody's reality. When they say somebody's strong tower, it is somebody's reality. Why don't you praise God and glorify God for this?
this miracle tonight. Say, my deliverer, 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 say, my breakthrough, 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 my breakthrough. Somebody give them praise all over the room. Listen, even as Pastor was talking, I just really feel like what God is trying to show us in the natural, He's trying to release to us in the spiritual. That the enemy's judgment on your life said that you were supposed to be bound for 10, 20 years, for 30 years. But I hear the Spirit of the Lord say, just like Brother Carlos was released in 5 months, five is the number of grace and favor. The Lord says what grace is about to do in your life. It's about to break every chain. It's about to break every fetter. It's about to loose every bound. And the reason why we can't stay bound any longer is because the Bible says if we speak and declare anything in the name that is above every name, somebody shout, it's in the name of Jesus. Come on, shout again, it's in the name of Jesus. Come on, one more time, everything I need is in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Resurrection power. pushing back the darkness, lighting up the kingdom that cannot be shaken. In the name of Jesus, enemies defeated, and we will shout it out, shout it out. God is fighting for us, pushing back the darkness, lighting up the kingdom that could not be shaken. In the name of Jesus, enemies defeated, and we will shout it out, shout it out. God is fighting for us, pushing back the darkness, lighting up the kingdom that cannot be shaken. In the name of Jesus, enemies defeated, and we will shout it out, shout it out.
Shout it out, shout it out.
Jesus, come alive in the name of Jesus. Come
say, you will live. You will not die. Come on and turn around. If you're already connected to God, you don't have to. You don't have to. Just stay connected to the Lord. But if you're still focusing a little bit, I want you to encourage somebody and prophesy to their heart, to their spirit, that you will live. You will not die. God didn't bring you this far to leave you here. God didn't bring you this far so that he could see you fail and fall. As long as you hold on to the hand of the master, yeah, you're coming alive. Yeah. Say, I'm coming alive. Come on and shout it out. I'm coming alive. I'm coming alive. Children, right now in Jesus' name, just begin to say, I declare life, eternal life in my children, in my home, upon my husband, or if you're a husband, upon your wife. Begin to declare the life of Jesus, hallelujah, in your family, in your home, upon your relatives. Just declare the life of Christ. We no longer live to this flesh, but we live for Christ. The old is past. And the new has come. Hallelujah. The life of Jesus in our homes right now. In Jesus' name. Yes. I'm alive. I'm alive. In you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 And we will make it known. Jesus is alive. He's alive. He's alive. He's alive. And he lives inside of me. Yes, I will make him known. Jesus is alive. He's alive. Serve a living God. Yes, and we will make it known. Jesus is alive. He's alive. Come on and shout, he's alive. He's living inside of me. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Alive in me, Jesus. Alive in me, Jesus. Oh, breathe your life into my love. Breathe your life into my being, God. And I will make it known. Jesus is alive. He's alive. He's growing me into a being to be just like him. Hallelujah. So I just want to encourage somebody here that feels like I haven't been growing. I don't know what's going on, but I want to encourage you in the Lord that if you are connected to Jesus, he's taking care of that. And he will make sure that you grow up in him. Hallelujah. Don't you fear and don't you fret because you feel like you've taken some steps backward or you've come off the track just a little bit. Just take this moment and say, God, just bring me back. Align me back to your will, God. Align me back to the path of life. Hallelujah. If that's you here today, just begin to lift your voice to the Lord. Begin to lift your life and heart to God. Align me back, God. And even if I don't even realize that I've gone astray, Father, just bring me back. Yes, God, bring me back to you. Hallelujah. Bring me back to you, Jesus. closer walk with you.
It's our heart's desire, Lord. It's our heart's cry today, oh God, to be more like you, be more like you. It's our heart's cry today. It's our heart's cry today to be more like you.
More and more, we want you.
Every second of every hour, we cry for more. God, we want you. We want you. Now we need you. We need you. We want you. We want you. We want you, oh Lord. Isaiah 58 talks about that this is a fast that the Lord has chosen to break every band of wickedness and to set the captive free. And it says when we begin to fast and we begin to turn away our plate and we begin to restrain from the things of this world, it goes on to say in the 12th verse of that chapter that then shall our light come. And then shall it spring forth. And it says, and the glory of the Lord shall begin to be our rear guard. Or in other words, the glory of the Lord shall begin to back up everything that he has commanded us to do. I just really sense that there's glory that is in this atmosphere right now. That if we would begin to just lift our hands in complete surrender and say, God, I'm not just fasting these 21 days simply just to miss a meal, or I'm not just fasting, God, these 21 days to move away from people. But God, I'm fasting these 21 days because I want to let you know through my action that I need your glory to push me. I need your glory to overshadow me. I need your glory to get in the middle of everything that I'm doing. I need the weight of you, God. So if we could just lift a hand or two, just even in this atmosphere right now, how we need your glory to fully embrace, us. To fully capture us, God. Oh, we need your glory. Oh, Lord, I just want you more. More. I just want you. Oh, Lord, I just want you more. Matchless love and beauty, endless worth, and nothing in this world will satisfy me. Why I cry for more? Cause Jesus, you're the cup that a woman drank. We say your presence is heaven. Sing out, sing out. Sounds good, AJC. Sing it out a little bit louder. Your presence, Lord. The holder of my future, Redeemer of my past and present, He's a holder of my future, holder of my future days, Redeemer Redeemer of my past and present. He's the holder of my future. Now come on, let's shout it out. Your presence, say your presence. That's it, shout it out with everything in you. It's where I wanna be, it's where I wanna be, it's where I wanna be, your presence.
Every voice lifted, Lord Jesus, we strive to see your face, Lord Jesus. We just seek you, Lord Jesus. Come on, church, we're at the hem of his garment right now, Lord Jesus. Just keep pushing, Lord. Lord Jesus, hallelujah, Lord Jesus. every stronghold that may be have you bound, Lord Jesus. In that deepest valley, Lord Jesus, you are with us, Lord God. And see many of all your faces, familiar faces, but we strive to see those new faces, those guests, those people that we bring in that don't know his love, but we strive to show him his love. Amen. You are already God's favorite. Amen. At this time, if the ushers can please make their ways up. Lord, at this time, we ask that you just bless this offering, Lord Jesus, because you know every financial struggle, Lord Jesus. You know every financial need that we may have, Lord Jesus. But Lord, we rely on you, Lord Jesus, in your mighty name. Amen.
Feel great in the presence of the Lord. How many feel young in the presence of the Lord? Amen. In the presence of the Lord, there is fullness of joy. Even up to today, but I remember when my wife and I were dating, an hour conversating with the woman of my dreams wasn't enough. We could do it all night, just talking. Talking, and it would never get old. And when you just fall in love with Jesus, yes, an hour just seems like 10 minutes. 2 hours. This is what we give God. Amen. When we preach the word, it's nothing new to him. But when we give God a new song, a new praise, when we are able to open up our heart and be like David and just fully expose our life and just say, God, I just need you, and I want you to come to every area of our lives, so we become more like him. Amen. Hebrews 11:6 says, without faith, it is impossible to please the Lord. Because anyone who comes to him must believe that he exists and that he rewards those who earnestly seek him. And that's what we are doing in 21 days. We are establishing habits that will carry on for the rest of the year, for the rest of our life, to seek him. Seek what pleases the Lord. Amen. If you could be so kind to open your Bibles to Exodus 25, verse 10 through 15. The best investment you can make this year so far is two things: to get to the house of the Lord, develop a relationship with God. The second thing is get to General Assembly this Saturday morning, 6 to noon. You got the rest of the day. You will leave here so renewed, refreshed. We have, we have times of prayer, but we have Bible devotional times. We have time of, fellowship. And then you got 6 hours that somebody's watching your kids. That is a blessing from God. Amen. And they already have activities. And the Exodus 25 verse 12 to 15, we just love everybody that's here today. Welcome. You made it second Sunday of the year. Great way to start off the year. And the word of the Lord says, cast 4 gold rings for it and hasten them to its 4 feet, and with 2 rings on one side and 2 rings on the other. Then make poles of acacia wood and overlay them with gold. Insert the poles into the rings on the side of the ark to carry it. I want to focus on this portion of scripture. Insert the poles into the rings on the side of the ark to carry it. For the poles are to remain in the rings of this ark, for they are not to be removed. Let's go to 2 Samuel chapter 6, verse 2 and 10. Last week we preached on don't let people limit your praise. What a time we had. What a way to start off the year. Amen. We had so much to be grateful for and to go into the year praising the Lord. 2 Samuel chapter 6, verse 2 and 10 says, and he and all his men went to Baal, Judah, to bring up from there the ark of God, which is called by the name of the Lord Almighty, who is enthroned between the cherubim on the ark. And they set the ark of God on a new cart. Everybody say, a new cart. Amen. How many know we always have a new idea, a new way, just to get by? God doesn't want us to get by. God is not moved by your creativity just to show up to church and not lead change and not give glory to God and just say, hey, but at least I showed up to church. And brought it to the, and brought it from the house of Abinadab, which was on the hill. And Lizah and Allo, sons of Abinadab, were guiding the new cart. Everybody say, the new cart. With the ark of God on it. And Allo was walking in front of it, and David and all of Israel were celebrating with their might before the Lord with castanets and harps and lyres and timbrels and sistrums and cymbals. And when they came to the threshing floor of Nacon, Uzzah reached out and took hold of the ark of God because the oxen stumbled, and the Lord's anger burned against Uzzah because of its irreverent act. Therefore, God struck him down, and he died there beside the ark of God. Verse 8. Then David was angry because the Lord's wrath had broken out against Uzzah, and to this day, that place is called Perez.
It was in verse 9. And David was afraid of the Lord that day and said, how can the ark of the Lord ever come to me? And he was not willing to take the ark of the Lord to be with him in the city of David. Instead, he took it to the house of Obed-Edom, the Gittite. I want to preach for a few moments. And if the Lord would just guide me, I pray that it would be few so we can just continue to enjoy his presence. On the subject, don't let failure limit your praise. Amen. Turn to your neighbor and say, don't let failure limit your praise. I don't care what you did in 2015. It's a new year. It's a new day. And his mercies are new. Learn. Amen. Don't let failure limit your praise. You may be seated. The Ark of the Covenant was a wooden box that carried manna from the desert, Aaron's rod that sprouted in the Ten Commandments. It was overlaid with gold and two cherubims. Angels faced each other. The ark was a manifestation of God's physical presence on earth. It was the Shekinah glory. God would speak to Moses in the tent of meeting in the desert between the two cherubims. It was holy and it was sacred. It was where the presence of God would come and meet his people, and everywhere the Israelites went in, the ark led the way. It brought victory because God's presence is the only thing that can bring real victory in your life. How many believe that? That God's presence can, he's the only one that can bring real victory into your life. Unfortunately, the ark was taken from Israel by the Philistines. And the Philistines then abandoned it because instead of blessings, it was bringing a lot of problems, because God doesn't just rest on any heart. God doesn't just bless anybody just because, hey, I know that church and I'm going to be part of the blessing. God is looking for a pure heart. God is looking for a heart that is open and that is reverent to the things of God. And what Israel had in the presence of God, the Philistines couldn't match it. They actually said, we need to get rid of this ark. And as David became king, he desired to bring the ark into the city of David. He had a great passion and aspiration for the presence of God to be amongst them in a city called Jerusalem. It was a good idea, but it was executed wrong. I want us in 2016 to get it right. We've had failures in 2012. Come on, somebody. Since 1988, it's just been a cycle over and over and over again. But I believe as we are consecrating to the Lord, as we are devoted to God's word and to his presence, I believe the spirit of God that is in you is going to quicken your spirit to get it right this year. You might have had some failures. You might have had some setbacks. You might have had some pride that blinded your success. But today is a new day. We're going to learn from our past and we're going to give God glory because we're still here and we're still able. I wish I had some real people that said, yes, I messed up. Yes, I went astray. But by the grace of God, it is a new day. It is a new place of mercy. And I'm going to learn it right this time. We can do so many things in the name of God and it's not in God's word or God's plan. David said, I'm going to build a city. We're going to move this ark. We're going to take it. It was a good idea, but it was executed wrong. Amen. We got to be so careful as God continues to bless these congregations of AJC and our 10 a.m. service, our 1 p.m. service, our 6 p.m. service. Amen. Listen, As long as God starts blessing and growing and increase, we got to remember never to forget the details. Because God is a God of details. And He is not concerned about your resources or your ability as much as He is concerned about your obedience. Amen. David got to a place where his ambitions and his pride got the best of him. Amen. He superseded the counsel of God. He superseded the word of God and his ambitions and pride that said, I'm king now, and this city is going to be recognized by the presence of God. And God's looking at him and said, that's good, but your plans are off. Amen. God wants your marriage to be restored. God wants your marriage to be strengthened, but not at the expense of your relationship with God. Not at your expense of disconnecting to the body of Christ. God says you might have some good plans, but it's not the right plans. Amen. David, he said, well, this is the way it's going to do. You ever talk to somebody that they're just hard-headed? Amen. Plans always get us in trouble, because if they do not include humility and obedience to God's word, it is a recipe for destruction. Amen. Proverbs 15:22 says, plans fail for the lack of counsel, but many advisors, they succeed. I want to tell you here today, and I don't want to fluff up my feathers, and I don't want to remind you that I'm the pastor, but God has placed me in this church for a reason, to give you counsel and to be your voice. And if you do not hear it, it is a recipe for destruction. God has given you the word of God so that you can read it and you can obey it, and if you do not read it and obey it, it is a recipe for destruction. But this year in 2016, I am going to learn from my mistakes. I'm going to be a better man of God. I'm going to be a better woman of God. I'm going to be quick to receive instruction. I'm going to be quick to receive the word of God. I'm not going to let pride and ambition blind me from success. I wish I had somebody to high five your neighbor and say, are you hearing? Amen. This is a good word, because I'm not going to go another year with your pride, with your arrogance, with your stubborn self. David, somebody's going to get killed. Something is going to happen. Just read the word of God. I hear the Spirit of the Lord telling you, you don't need gimmicks. You don't need another tool. What you need is get into the Word of God. Be open to what God says over your life and obey it. Amen. Praise God. My God, pastor's on fire. I know. Every January he is. My God. Invite a friend next week. Amen. For a moment, David was blinded by ambition. Proverbs 18, verse 1 and 2 says, whoever isolates himself seeks his own desires. Amen. He breaks out against all sound judgment, and a fool takes no pleasure in understanding, but only in expressing his opinion. Come on, somebody. And I believe that the priest and David's counsel said, David, we want revival as much as you want it. We want the ark to come, but you're missing the point. You can't put the ark on a thing. We got two poles. Come on, somebody. There's rings that we slide those poles on. The presence of God is never meant to rest on things. It is meant to rest on people.
The presence of God, what we are experiencing here tonight, is God's divine will. He says, I want to live in you. I want my presence to rest on you. I want to have a prayer relationship with you. I want the anointing of God to flow through you. I don't want to be on your agenda. I don't want to be part of your calendar. I don't want you to say, well, I'm a mother, so I'm tapping out. I'm having some marriage problems, so I'm going to take some time out. He say, no, I need the presence of God to flow on you. That is the purpose of my presence. And I want to tell the church today, what we are experiencing here today is the divine will of God. It's the presence of God that says, I want to be put on you. And it's a little bit heavy. And it's going to cause you to come on. I wish I had somebody. Man, your knees start shaking. Your spirit starts cracking. And God says, my glory wants to rest upon you. Not your money. Not your talent. I need my presence to rest on you. Don't let pride and ambition blind us from truth. Matthew chapter 6 verse 33 says, seek first the kingdom of God. Seek first the kingdom of God. Well, you know, I'm busy. I got a new promotion at job. And I got this. And I, well, guess what? There's no excuse why you can't pray. Well, I got 5 kids. Well, stop having them. Amen. Well, you know, I got, God bless me with, you know, with this and that, and I got all kinds of responsibility. And let me tell you something. You know, job is good. Raising kids is good. A promotion at your job is good. But the presence of God doesn't rest upon your job. It doesn't rest upon your ministry. It doesn't rest upon your money. It rests on people, and people that are open for God to live in them and so and work through them to do something powerful on earth. Amen. Don't forget the details, because we can get so caught up busy. We need to stop and we need to pray. No, I need a vacuum. I need a clean. I need a details. What does the word of God say? Seek first the kingdom of God. Seek first the kingdom of God and all his righteousness. Nothing should ever supersede your relationship with God. Schooling, work. Amen. Aspiration. Nothing should take the place. I'm sorry. Some of you have a strong, prideful spirit like David. Ain't nobody going to tell. We're going to move. I'm the king. We're going to move this ark. And I need the choir here. And I need Brother Mike to have the musicians present, because we're going to have a church. The presence of God is going to come into Jerusalem, and God. Oh, good. David. You are in the position that you are in because you are humble. You are in the position that you are in because in lonely places, you were willing to worship me. You were willing to hear my voice. And you were willing to do what I have called you to do. And in 2016, there's going to be so many opportunities and blessings over this church, over your life, over your marriage, all kinds of things that are going to come. But I want you to remember, do not forget the details, the things that matter. The things that bring genuine and true success. Amen. Hebrews chapter 11 verse 6 says that he rewards those that earnestly seek him. Church, there's nothing greater than to seek the Lord, to seek what he loves, to seek what he hates, to seek his heart. What is he thinking about you? What's his thoughts towards you? This is what moved God about David, because David would be willing to say, okay, God, here I am. I'm messed up. I'm just a little
overlooked by my dad and nobody believes in me. And you know, but you're still awesome. And I love you and I praise you. And so what are you trying to tell me? What are you speaking into my life? You always got to be open to hear God. Amen. And David, he started off right, but something went wrong at this moment. And just want to remind AJC that we get in trouble when we don't do our homework. I said we get in trouble when we don't do our homework. We need to get right in the Word. And we need to know what God is speaking into our lives for this year, for your life. Are you seeking Him? Are you asking Him what He is thinking about you and what He wants from you? Because for a moment, David lost himself with pride and with ambition and with being busy. And David, for the most of his life, he loved this longing for God and instruction. And then for a moment, he lost it. We need to be open for God to rebuke us. And be open. This altar needs to be, you know what? Your greatest moments will be right here in the altar. Greatest moments will be opening and pouring your heart and your life before God in your private time with God. Remember, your greatest moments have been, God, I want to know more of you. I want to know you. I want to love upon you. 1 hour is nothing. 2 hours is nothing. 3 hours is nothing. Just to be in the presence of God. The priest and the elders probably told David, King, if you're going to bring the ark, don't forget the ringlets and poles. And I just feel the Spirit of God moving upon my heart to tell the church, don't forget the ringlets and the poles. Don't you forget that my presence is supposed to be carried, that my presence is to be upon you, not upon things, not upon busyness, not upon anything else. Don't you forget the details of your life. But David said, no, it's a new cart. I have a new plan. I have a new idea. I have a new way to, you know, start off the year right. If it doesn't include God's word, and if it doesn't include Him being first and center of your life, it's already off. I'm going to tell you that one more time. I don't care what your plans are. Well, we're going to go to Bahamas this year for my family to be strengthened. But if they are not reading God's word, if you're not putting God center in your life, guess what? You're going to have a good suntan, but it's not going to restore the joy that God has given you. And it's only going to be when you get into the word of God, when you apply the word of God, when you obey the word. I wish I had somebody here today that says, I'm tired of pride and ambition leading me astray. I'm tired of being offended. I'm tired of being upset. I'm tired of going 3 months not praying and reading the word of God and then sinning and falling. This year is a new year. I made some mistakes, but you cannot count me out. The grace of God is speaking over my life, and He's saying, in the midst of your failure, I still want to lay on you. I still want to rest on you. I still want to speak into you. I still want to use you. I know you failed. I know you messed up, but get on up, because my power is greater than your failure. I wish I had somebody get up on your feet and give God a comeback praise. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Turn to your neighbor and say, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. I said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. I was a drug addict. I was locked up. I was a liar. I was about to leave my family. But the Spirit of the Lord, I said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. And everywhere the ark went, there was victory. Everywhere the ark went, their enemies trembled. I want want you to remind the devil, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me right. Come on, somebody, walk into your battlefield. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. We're going to have victory. We're going to have deliverance. Yeah. 30 seconds, raise your voice and praise the one true living God. Hallelujah. 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 Amen. The ringlets and the poles is what drives us crazy in our spiritual life. The inability to follow details in the Word of God will be your biggest problem in 2016. Amen. The ringlets and the poles. Somebody needs to write that down. Somebody needs it. The ringlets and the poles are the details that matter in my life. It's the obedience. It's the obedience that's going to take our church. It's going to take your family to higher levels. David insisted for the ark to be put on a new cart. He insisted that the presence of God would not be carried, but it would be on a cart. And a new form would take it to the city of God. And God says, my word never changes. It's the same yesterday, today, and forever. Let me tell you something, church. Sin is still sin. Maybe you got too comfortable with glory and revival in the church, but I still want to tell you, sin is still sin. And if you're not doing things according to the Word of God, it's going to catch up. Amen. And we find out that because of David's inability to read the details, it caused somebody's life, and it caused a setback to David's plans. Our inability to follow God's word will bring setback. God has spoken over this congregation. He says, I know you got visions, I know you got goals, but continue to give to missions. Continue to make my name great in your worship services, in your personal life. I'll do the rest. Just seek me. Just follow my heart. Just follow what I desire. Go make new friends. Go connect to somebody and grow them in the Lord. When you are doing what God is calling you to do, God will bring the increase. Amen. How many are here today because somebody took you to coffee? Somebody took you to McDonald's after church? Somebody taught you the Word of God? Somebody taught you that, this is a crazy church. You ready for it? You know, we deny ourselves and take up our cross, and it's that kind of church. And it's when we're discipling, when we're loving God, and when we are given to missions, we are the happiest. We are the most joyful. It is the reason why the Spirit of God is resting upon you. The ringlets and the poles in 2016 over your life, if you overlook the details, is just loving God, loving people, forgive your enemies, give God the tenth. Be anxious in nothing, but in everything in prayer, forsaking not the assemblies of the brethren. And brothers, these are the ringlets and the poles that sustain us and bring us great victory. And we cannot overlook even the smallest of commands of the Bible. We cannot overlook the smallest. I made a decision. I was at an amazing time last night. We were with some of the young couples, and we had a glorious time. And we were laughing, and I won't tell you what game we were playing, but it was a spiritual game. And amen. And I told them at the end, I said, let's pray. And I said, I made a New Year resolution. Yes, I did. I said, God, I understand I am on the potter's wheel. I understand that I'm a work in progress. And I'm going to offend people and I'm going to hurt people. But as much as I'm expecting people to forgive me, the same I'm going to require when somebody falls short, when somebody messes up, when somebody, I'm not going to sit here this year, be bitter and upset and offended and come up with new schemes to be joyful and happy. This year, this month, you like pink. Next month, you like black. Next month, you like Macy's. The following month, you like JCPenney. I mean, nothing can fulfill your spirit and your longings. Why? Because it's only Jesus. Jesus is the only one that can make you happy, that can complete you. And you can look for all the things in this world, and you'll never find it like Jesus Christ. I'm determined to be happy. No, forget happy. I'm determined to be joyful. Happiness is only when good things happen. I'm determined every day to get out of my bed, whether I like it or not, and be glorify God and say, God, you're resting upon me for a purpose. I'm alive here today so that AJC can do some great damage to the gates. I wish somebody would stand upon your feet and say, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me to do something great. I dare somebody say, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me to be the devil's worst nightmare. Can we believe that? Amen. The moment you wake up, you need to remind the devil, I'm getting out of bed and I'm going to give God the glory. I'm still here. I might have messed up. I might have went my way. But guess what? It's a new day. It's a new opportunity. I feel real quick in 30 seconds. Somebody, come back, praise. Somebody, get up on your feet and say, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. Hallelujah. Real quick, turn to your neighbor and say, you're blessed. Because the Spirit of the Lord is upon me to bless you, to pray for you, to rebuke the devils that are trying to destroy your home. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me.
Amen. Hallelujah.
David, this is what gets the heart of God. Is that David realized I messed up. David, I want to tell you, the greatest way to start this year, just realize I'm not going in the right direction. The greatest way to come back is to realize I'm not praying like I should. I'm not reading God's word like I should. I'm not forgiving like I should. Let me tell you something. If you don't get rid of offense today, it's going to kill you in June. It's going to kill you. Oh, it's just a little chihuahua. Yeah, it's really a lion. And a lion can't be a house pet. He'll snap back at you, just kill you. Amen. You got to make up your mind. I'm not going to live offended. I am not going to live with unforgiveness. I'm not going to live with ambition blinding me. I want more of God. And when the Spirit of the Lord, when you feel the Spirit of the Lord, when the Spirit of the Lord is tangible like it is today, it is a reminder that is His sole purpose. It's to rest and to move upon people, not things. Amen. Not your house, not upon your car. He wants you to rest This is why, my visiting friend, you will find hands just raised up. And you'll have people falling on their knees. Men, women, young people. You know why? Because they realize, I need God. I need His direction, because at any moment when I forget the details of my life, it can affect somebody. I've seen families just walk out from God and their children never recover. Their children never find their way back to God. Let me tell you something. Don't let your pride and ambitions kill the dearest people in your life. Seeing marriages fall apart once God is not the center of their life. I want to tell you something. If the details are off in your life, everything's going to be off. My God. If the details of God's word is off in your life, everything's going to be off. And I want this church to love God more than ever. I want this church to be so passionate in lifting up Jesus and ready to, you know, just glorify God and just crying out and say, God, I need you. But it ends in a good note, because David, he didn't let his failure destroy him. He found the details that he left out and was obedient. And this is how we overcome failure, is to obey God's word this time around. It was our disobedience that got us into trouble, but that was the first time. This time we're going to learn. And it's to be obedient. And in 1 Chronicles chapter 15, verse 12 to 15, it says, he said to them, this is David. He's going back to the ark. He heard that Obadiah is just blessed beyond everything. One thing that I've been just desiring is just God, that I would be more zealous for God's presence. That I would want it. If the anointing and the calling's upon somebody, I want it. It's the same spirit. It's the same kind. God is blessing another church. I want it. I want to desire more than ever the presence of God manifested and demonstrated in our life like never before. He said, you are the heads of the Levitical families. You and your fellow Levites are to consecrate yourselves and bring up the ark of the Lord, the God of Israel, to the place I have prepared for it. For it was because you, the Levites, did not bring it up the first time that the Lord, our God, broke out in anger. He got it. You just got to get it, church. I just feel so burning and just to tell that you got to get that the areas that you are struggling with, you got to admit. You can't be blaming so-and-so, and it's because of my wife, and it's because of my dad, and it's because of this, it's because of that. You got to realize, man, I let pride and ambition take the best out of me. I forgot the details of God's word, and you know what? And it was catastrophic, and it cost somebody's life, and I should have died instead of this individual. But you know what? It's a new moment. It's a new season. It's a new time. And that same blessing that is upon Obed-Edom is going to come into the city of our God. And we're going to be blessed. And we're going to worship the Lord. And our family is going to be stronger than ever. And we're going to pray together. And we're going to make God our center focus. You need to start this year, church, coming to terms in your mistakes, in your failures, and say, we're going to go back to what matters. And that is seeking God with everything that we have. My God. And he said, we did not inquire of him about how to do it in the prescribed way. My God, David is understanding. I get it. He's not running from it. He said, We didn't inquire in the details of life. Don't you forget the ringlets in the poles. Don't you forget loving God. Don't you forget loving people. Don't you forget forgiving. Don't you forget not forsaking the assembly of the body of Christ, of the church, of the believers. Don't you forget worshiping and praising God. Don't you forget the details of your life that keeps your life in focus and in order. So the priests and Levites consecrated themselves in order to bring up the Ark of the Covenant, the God of Israel. And the Levites carried the Ark of God with the poles on their shoulders, as Moses had commanded in the accordance of the word of God. Yes, it does say here, we got to do it. And we got to live it, and we got to obey it. Your greatest freedom, church, is obeying the word of God. David was able to dance with all of his might like last Sunday. We did, and we praised God like David did. But the reason why he praised God is because his freedom came through obedience. Obedience, the smallest thing. What is it? Get the poles, put it in the rings, and carry the ark. What is it? Love God. Love people. Forgive. Man, somebody here today can praise God. Somebody here can leap off your seat. Why? Because you know what it is to be obedient. And you see the blessings of God. Are there 10 people that can testify serving God and obeying Him has been the best decision of your life? Man, if God wants me to wake up and pray, why not? If God wants me to twirl around, why not? Brother Robert, come here, man. Come here. Man, we had like a non-coffee appointment. Get up here. Amen. We were at Starbucks and we were just fellowshipping. Man, he was on fire. He was on fire. I got in my car and I was like, on fire. Amen. Listen, he's come a long way. He's come a long way. I want you to testify on how good God is in your life. Come on, I want you to just, you can look at me and just do it, but come on, just tell them, because this is why we leap. This is why we skip. This is why we twirl. Why? Because obedience is freedom. I said obedience is freedom. When we obey God, we got the freedom and the blessings of God to move forward.
Amen. I'm nervous. Well, I've been dealing with the anxiety for like, I don't know, I want to say like 4 months. And I don't know, man, it seems like I was dying, you know what I mean? Those days that I wasn't even eating, I lost about, I want to say 20 pounds. And when I would come to church, I just wanted to leave, you know, because I was just feeling that panicky stuff. And I wouldn't be eating at work. I got to leave. But they already knew the situation that I was going through right now. And this past, I want to say a week or 2 weeks, no, probably a week, kicked it out the curb, you know. I haven't been having these anxiety no more. My wife, she gets all frustrated with me. I would tell her to drive me to work because I couldn't be driving. I'll be panicking, so I have to stop. And I'm like, man, call Miguel, hey, come pick me up. And he came through. Sorry, I'm learning how to talk, you know, sometimes. But, I mean, I come from the hood, you know. And I'm just... And, I'm learning, you know what I mean? I always talk to God and tell him, you know, lead me the right direction and teach me how to talk, you know? But sometimes I sound ghetto, but, you know. But yeah, there's still a lot I got to say, but I'm kind of nervous right now.
How long have you been free from alcohol?
Yeah, I've been sober for a year and 6 months. I used to chase that beer, you know, like it was candy. I would go to work, and then after work, I would go to the bar. My family waiting for me at home. I would get home about, I would get out of work at 2:30. I would get home by 6:30 or 7. I would go bar hopping with my friends and stuff. But, I mean, now that I've been serving the Lord, I don't crave that beer no more, you know. Yeah. Like, my cousin invited me to his wedding the other a couple months ago. I went over there. They were all drunk and stuff, and I was like, man, I gotta go. But I wasn't craving it, you know. I just had to leave. But yeah, God healed me. God's.
Excited for that.
I'm just excited that now I know God's good because he delivered me, you know what I mean, from these anxiety that I was having.
Amen.
But I thought I was going to die, but I'm still here.
So that's why he's running around the church, because his comeback is greater than his faults from his faith. I wish I had somebody leap up and say, I had my moments of pride and ambition, but by the grace of God, I'm here today.
Amen. Give me 5 minutes. I want you to church your neighbor and tell them, you see me praising God? You have no idea what I went through and what I've learned to get where I'm here today. So if you can do me a favor, and if you could just praise God with me, because we're moving forward, God is upon me, and we're going to see the greatest revival that we have. I wish I had somebody get out of your seat. I survived. Church, your neighbor, say, I'm free. I'm free. I was caught up. I was bound up. But by the grace of God. Now it leads us to where the story ends. David's wife was saying, David, you're acting crazy. You shouldn't be praising God like this. But if you knew what I've been through. I said if you knew what I've been through. Sister, you would be praising too. You would be glory. Brother Carlos done left. The details. The details. We're going to do something real quick. Then we're going to move on. The details. What does the detail says? Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Come on, sir. The detail. I don't need to do it. Let everything that... It's the little things that matters. I did somebody real quick. Yes. The Spirit of the Lord is upon you, Brother Israel. The Spirit of the Lord is upon you. The Spirit of the Lord is upon this house. The Spirit of the Lord is upon this youth group.
Hallelujah. Don't forget the small things. Don't forget the smallest of details in your life is going to produce the comeback that you need for this year. There is an anointing upon every one of you in this congregation. You are here for a specific reason, to be loved by God. Everybody throughout this house is here so that God can only love upon you. And he wants to rest upon you. And with an open heart, he will come. And he will rest, not upon things, but upon people. Now I want you to remember, don't forget the ringlets and the poles. Don't you forget the small things that matter. Because for God, obedience is everything. Now I'm going to challenge this whole congregation for a few moments of you, all throughout this house. That you would just let God come upon you. Just let the Spirit of God rest upon you and love upon you. I don't care where you came from. I don't care what your past is. I don't care what your battles was. The most important thing is you made it. The most important part is you're here today. We're all struggling. We've all had our moments. But we got to come to the realization there were some things we didn't do. There were some things that I didn't obey that led to a setback. I want everybody here today, I pray that you would just have an open heart these next 10 minutes. Just have an open heart to just allow God to speak into your life. Let God rebuke your life. Let God love upon your life. Because a heart after God is a heart that is open and willing to love what God loves. I want everybody just to raise your hand for a moment throughout this house. What we experience all throughout this worship service, God wants to be upon each and every one of you. All throughout this house. Yeah, I'm not looking for your busyness. I'm not looking to rest upon your business, on your things in your home. I'm looking for a house, a heart. That heart is here today. For the next few moments, why don't you just open up your heart and just say, God, it's the details that always send me back. It's the details that always throws me off. It's the details of me not obeying even the smallest of things of what you're asking. That causes me to go straight. Every hand raised all throughout this house. You can sing that song that you sang, I Need You More than ever. We just want to produce a heart. It says, God, before I take another step, are you really in it? Are you really in this? Am I loving you with everything that I got? Am I really serving? Loving people, forgiving, giving. Be a heart checkup. Why don't we learn from David's mistake? And why don't we respond like David did and say, you know, I didn't do my homework.
Young people, I beg you, do your homework. Read the word. Before you get into relationships, read the word. Read the word. Read the word. This is our hour, church. I want to challenge worshipers here today that don't care who's around. Don't care who you are. You just want to know more of God. You just want God just to love upon you and rest upon you. I want you to get to this altar. Feel this altar. We got to move the chair. If somebody's here today for the first time, welcome. Welcome home. Welcome back. Well, you don't know what I did. You don't know what I... Just be like David. Okay, God. You know, I kind of... A little off guard. I got a little distracted and stopped praying and I stopped reading the word. And you know, I know I was supposed to, I've been hearing that all my life, but that's really what it is. There's nothing more, just distracted, just busy, just man. I was king for the day. And, God wants to rest upon everyone. Would you just raise your hands all throughout this hour? Oh, want to take another step without you, God. Don't want to go 2016. Don't go 2016 without you. Thank you, everybody. Yes, just come wherever you're at. Don't let failure limit your praise. David didn't. Don't you let failure limit your praise. Don't you let what you did in last year, 2 years ago, 3 years, don't you let that limit who you will become and what God wants from you, and that is praise. Jesus, raise your hand all throughout this.
I just want you.
You go.
I just want you.
There you go. Just be real with God. Just be real with God. Go with God. If you have the ability to praise God, it's not final. Your failure is not final. If you have this ability to change, to see God and say, God, there's a new day. This is the new moment. I'm going to serve you. I'm going to follow even those little minute details that matters to you. They matter to you. Loving you matters. So, Father, I enter into this right now. Why don't you just raise your hands? There you go. Raise your voice all throughout this house. All throughout this house. Church isn't just, it's not enough. Having money is not enough. You got to know God. You got to be open. You got to be passionate for God. God, I'm off. God, something isn't right.